Hey, so we saw your family today in clinic and got...
Like all common cancers, if you can catch them early and take them out, they are quite curable, and so surgery is still a mainstay for this cancer unless it's spread outside the colon. We know that hereditary risk or genetic risk for colon cancer, like most common cancers, occurs in probably about 10 to 20% of families, meaning that there's more occurrences of colon cancer in a family than you'd predict just based on average. There's two main hereditary syndromes that result in colon cancer. The main one is Lynch syndrome. That accounts for about 2 or 3% of all colon cancer. So there's four main genes that, when altered or mutated and inherited from a parent, can result in colon cancer or Lynch syndrome. And they're called MLH1, MSH2, MSH6, and PMS2. And if they're altered, if they look abnormal or are missing, that's a key to tell us we should go look more deeply if they are defective in the inherited DNA of that person. The other main hereditary cancer syndrome is called familial adenomatous polyposis, or FAP. One gets many, sometimes hundreds or thousands of polyps in the colon, as opposed to just a few, and often at a really young age, even teenagers. When anyone's diagnosed with colon cancer, one thinks about family history. So here at Stanford, every colon cancer that's diagnosed, they do some special tests in addition to all the standard pathology tests. If one does have these abnormal changes, these patients are referred to our cancer genetics clinic. We have five or six genetic counselors who would see a family like this and dig much deeper into their family history, what kinds of cancers and other medical issues are going on in that family, and decide if we should go ahead with genetic testing. How likely is it, if you inherit a change in a gene, are you going to develop the trait or the disease? In this case, what one inherits with the altered gene is the risk of colon cancer. And we actually know very well how likely it is. Over a lifetime, it's about 3/4 of individuals will get colon cancer. And that risk starts as young as the mid-30s or even late 20s. These high-risk families, Lynch syndrome, when we do diagnose them, what can we do? Well, for family members that are unaffected, so they inherited that gene, they haven't had a cancer, we would recommend starting colonoscopies as young as 25. Doing it every year or two, as opposed to every 5 to 10 years. And for women, examining the endometrium and sometimes even removing that at a later age, around 40, to deal with their elevated endometrial cancer risk, which is also part of Lynch syndrome.